Hi everyone, welcome to the channel. My name's Will. Today on Delayed, I have a big old lump of sycamore. A piece of branch wood, big branch wood. So I'm going to have a go at turning a vase. So the piece is about 18 inches long by probably 8 inches in diameter. So I'm just roughing it down now to some bit of a round. That's the 1 1/4 inch spindle roughing gouge. I've had this piece sitting outside the workshop for maybe the last 6 8 months, so it's just started to spalt nicely. I think I got it just at the right time. I think I checked the moisture in it on, I think it was down to about 17% or something like that, but it's good enough for me to turn anyway. That's a 10 mil parting tool now, so I'm just going to put a tenon on it. I put a tenon on both sides of it because I wasn't sure what orientation I was going to use it. I think there might have been a crack in either end of it. I put my dovetail on now with the skew. So that's it, down to round now, so it's going into the chuck. That's the Nova Titan chuck. It's a big monster of a chuck. And it's a big piece of wood. Now I'm just going to start getting some bit of shape into it. Now just adding a line here, I think this is going to be the widest part of the vase, so it'll taper in from there, give or take. The 5/8 inch ball gouge I'm using. Beautiful piece of wood. It was cutting really, really nice. But then I think it's because the moisture was a little bit high in it. As I said, it was up around 17%, so slightly wetter wood always cuts nicer. now. That's the 1-inch scraper. It's just a standard scraper. So I'm just going to refine the shape. Time to shape the opening for the vase. As you seen earlier, I put it in on both sides. I wasn't quite sure which end I was going to have as the opening. Now it's time for the steady rest. This is a homemade steady rest I made myself. If anybody is interested in making one, a very good friend of mine, Brian J. Usby from Heartwood Turning, he done a great video on making this. And that's, I watched it a couple of times as I was making mine. So it's a very good tutorial as well. It's actually quite easy to make. All you need is a couple of, I think they're little skateboard wheels and little couple of little bolts and washers. You know, it didn't cost a lot. I think one sheet of plywood as well. So as you can see now, I'm just starting to drill out. I'm going to drill down the 13 or 14 inches down to the bottom of it with a Forstner bit. As you can see, I have the long extension there for a Forstner bit as well. That's just a bit of dry PTF spray, just to lubricate the bit. So just drilling it out, always just drill in an inch or so and retract it and take out the shavings and go again, because if the bit gets stuck in it, I'm afraid you're at the loss of your piece. So I have a 2-inch hole now all the way down to the bottom of the vase. So I'm just going to start flaring in the opening a bit, and I'll get started then on the hollowing. So that's the Simon Hope Pro Hollower with the little 6mm cupped carbide cutter on the tip. I said I'll be doing it freehand, I don't have a jig, so. As you can see, it makes life work of it. That's the little hooked tool just to get in under the rim a bit. So there's a little cut carbide cutter on it as well. Just allows you to undercut that. Now the hollowing commences again. Once I got down to about 8 inches or so, and it started to get a bit harder to hollow. You know, you need a really good grip on the tool. So I've just switched now. I've took the little straight cutter off and I've put a little angle cutter on it because I'm getting down quite far. So I find it just works a bit easier. I've used that hollowing tool down to about 8 inches before quite easily, but this is the first time now I went down. I think I went down to about 13 and a half inches with it now. As you can see, the tool is well extended. It was nice and steady, just nibble away. As I said, it wasn't a race. I was here one day just taking my time doing it. So now this is the Simon Hope negative rake scraper. I was just looking down the bottom, I had a little tiny little nub from left from the, or a little dimple left from the first nub bit. So I was just trying to get that. But again, nice gentle cuts when you're down that far in it, because your tool is well extended over the tool rest. So if it gets a catch, it's going to catch. So just nice and steady. That's the hollowing done. It's now time for sanding. So that's the little Simon Hope inertia sander, but the bar shaft actually fits perfect into the hollowing handle, the large hollowing handle. So it made a good long sander for me. I sanded the inside up to about 240 grit. Anyway, I don't think anyone's able to going to get their hand in anyway to feel how smooth it is. So now time to remove the steady rest. As I said, if anyone is interested in making one, just check out Brian Hart Returning. He done a great tutorial on making it. Just a little bit of a reshape on the opening of the vase, on the flared opening. Always a little design change as we go along. Giving another little shear scrape now just to refine it that little bit more. That's just a little 1 inch scraper just turned on its edge. Defining my cutoff point now. Yeah, that's that pencil mark there. That's as far as I hollowed down, so I need to extend it a little bit more. That's going to be the overall size. So now time for sanding. As you can see, I started there with a piece of 80 grit. And then just back to my usual method of sanding, my right angle drill. I think I took it up to about 400 grit and used the yellow Scotch-Brite pad just to give it a little rub after that. Ah, there it is. I'm not sure what grit they are. So now that's all the sanding finished. I sanded up to 400 grit and used the yellow Scotch-Brite pad then just to finish it off. I sanded the inside up to 240. Sanding the inside now was a bit of a pain. See what's the overall side. The overall length is just shy of 14 inches. So I got it hollowed down to a little over 13. So, which I think was pretty good, considering I had to do it by, I had no jig, I was just done it by hand. Now it did take a while to hollow it. I spent probably an hour and a half hollowing out the inside. But it's a beautiful piece of sycamore, some beautiful colour in it. It had just started to spalt. You can see some nice spalting in it as well here. So again, it's a beautiful piece of wood. It wasn't 100% dry. It was probably about 17-18%. But it was dry enough because I actually got it. I got it quite thin most of the way down. So I'll see on that camera. I'm gonna change the other one maybe. Can see here in the calipers, I've less than a half an inch all the way down, so well, as far as that will reach anyway. But I used the forcing of it to go all the way to the bottom first. So for a finish, I am thinking citrus burnishing oil. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go with citrus burnishing oil. So it's Hampshire Sheen citrus burnishing oil. Some beautiful colouring in it. It's soaking in quite well. I'll just do what I can reach on the inside for now. I'll put some on with a brush on the inside later. Just want to get a coat on the outside of it so you can all see the nice grain. Let that soak in for a minute and then we'll burnish it in. You can feel the paper towel getting hot, so it's building up a little bit of heat so it'll help absorb the oil into the wood.
looks amazing. Really happy with the colours. One little knot. I could feel that as I was hollowing. I'm going to leave it on the chuck overnight and I'll get another coat of oil on it tomorrow. For you, that'll be only a couple of seconds. So, yeah, I'm going to leave that dry. And I'll get definitely another one, maybe two coats on. So now I'm back at the lathe, which is the next morning for me. But for you, it's only been a second, so the oil has dried. So I'm going to apply a second coat. So again, it's the citrus burnishing oil from Hampshire Sheen. Just applying it with a paper towel. Wonderful smell when I came in the workshop this morning. Just get a nice good coat on. I'm just doing on the inside a little bit what I can reach with my finger. What I will do is, because it wasn't completely dry, this piece of wood, I won't oil the inside for a week or two, just to let it dry out a bit. And then I'll give it a coat or two on the inside. But on the inside, what I'll put on is lemon oil. Because obviously I won't be able to burnish the oil on the inside. Can't get my hand in. So I'll just fashion up some sort of a brush on a stick just to get the inside done. So now I'll just bring the speed up now on the lathe and I'll burnish this in. So I've got just 800 RPM there, which is loads. And again, just building up a little bit of heat into the paper towel just to burnish the oil into the wood. So now that has done the job. So now we'll get it parted off. I'm happy with that finish. So I got in as far as I could get just with my fingers. So as I said, I'm going to let it dry out a bit. So now I get rid of this oil and we'll get this parted off. So now, the parting tool, part it off. Going to chance cutting it anymore, so just use the handsaw. So now, just to get this piece sanded off the bottom. Sit there. Now, that's the base all sanded and oiled. It had a little bit of a crack in it. I just put a little bit of CA in it. Wasn't overly big. So, really happy with the result. So the inside was a bit of a mammoth task to hollow out. It did take me a good hour and a half to hollow that out. But I got it pretty good. So now, there we have it. There's a better look at it. So, for sycamore, it has some very nice colouring. It had just started to spalt. I think I got it just at the right time. So now that's a wrap on this one, guys. Our sycamore vase. It's just 14 inches tall. It's probably about 7 inches wide. Citrus burnishing oil for a finish. So as I said, I've still to oil the inside, but I might actually, because the wood was only about 17% moisture when I was turning it, so I'll let it dry a little bit more, but it will dry from the inside, so I'll get it finished then. So anyway, guys, that's a wrap on this one. So if you like this video, give me a subscribe, give me a like, and leave me a comment also and let me know what you think. And I shall catch us all in the next one. So take care, and bye for now.